some wood laying around, and I have these laying around. And I'm gonna make some sweet horseshoe pits for in the woods. And since I have a bunch of free wood that we milled a while back, we're gonna take those and use those. Okay, so tools we're gonna use a nail gun because we have a full box of nails. Nails are expensive right now. We have saw, square, pencil, tape, small compressor. Need a small compressor because we're running off a solar battery. We don't have power. And these are my redneck sawhorses. First of all, need to place these where you can cut on them. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. I drew it on here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make it 3 foot wide. That sticks out of the ground 15 inches. That doesn't matter yet. We're gonna make 1.5 inch sides, 1.5 feet sides, and they're gonna be 6 foot long total. So these will be 5 foot sections. These will be 6 foot. Now, we need to cut all these outsides first, and then we're gonna go over them with decking. And then we'll have a nice depth in the center that we can set our pin. Okay, always, first thing that you do, you always square the ends, even when you buy the junky 2x4s from the store. I've ever framed before. So square all your boards. Okay, so since our sides are going to be six foot, and we're going to have a 1 foot back on them, we're going to need to cut 4 sets at 6 foot. And since I know when I milled these, it's all the same. It came from the same log. I got an extra 8 inches on each. So I'm going to put a little bit of an angle on each after the 6 foot, just because I may leave them above ground for now, and I may dig a hole and put them in. I'm not sure yet. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to come down to 6 foot. We're going to mark it. And we know we got roughly an extra 8 on each. We're going to mark it twice. We're going to take our square. And I'm going to run that out relatively somewhere in there. So we'll say a 6, 6-12. Then we'll cut it off like this. And then we'll measure from there to the other end. And we'll be even. And then we'll have our pattern for the other side. Always use the same pattern, then you don't get accidentally longer or shorter from drawing your line. Works out well. Alright, so now we need a backboard for each side, so we're going to do 2 6-foot pieces. We're going to do this, obviously, mark it at 6 foot. And then when you mark your 12 foot, mark it at 12 foot and an eighth. And that'll take care of your saw blade and they'll be exactly the same. I like to check these for square both sides sometimes, just because of the fact that they're rough cut and some of them are a little squirrely. Something like that, and then a pin. Fantastic. All right, so what we gotta do, we know we come in a foot and a half, that's where we wanna be on the inside. Clearly that one goes on the inside of that, and just even if it's off a touch, we'll just measure from the other side because it's not that easy to do. Same thing. Measure your foot and a half, X to the inside, and we'll set our boards there. But we're going to square all of them. We know the ends are square because we cut those, but we're still going to square these. So everything's nice and straight. And then we'll put them together. Okay, if I didn't mention it, always wear your safety glasses because they can go off, like in the movies, but you need two hands. So we're gonna put these together and we're gonna level them to the top. I don't like shooting towards myself. We're gonna shoot that way, towards all the other stuff. Okay, here's the deal. Each one of those are 1.5 feet. You want to cap each, and then each center is 3. So we got to get our foot off the back. So we need 2 3s and 4 1.5 feet. So we're going to do 1.5 feet. Then we're going to do 1.5 feet and 1/8, which is 3 feet and 1/8. And then since this one's squirrely, we're going to get our 3 footer out of this one. So we're going to go 6 1/4 at our 1/8 for our saw. Then we're going to go to 9 3/8. Then our 1.5 feet. And 1/8, so that's 10 6.5. Then we'll be 12 5/8. And we'll square all those up and cut them off. Check this 3/8 or the 1/8 inch rule. So let's see. Come check this out. That's adding 1/8 to every cut. We're dead on. Alright, so these are going to cap the ends. So it really doesn't matter. We can go low and we can run our board over the top. That'll fill in that a little bit. And these run it at 1 foot, I think they call for. Yeah, that'll make it nicer. That's just so they don't get the heat off the bounce back. Next on the inside. And clearly do that to both sides. Okay, now that I already squared them, but I'm going to show you a trick to actually doing that, especially since you want to use 4 corners. Come up here, measure 3 foot to 3 4 5. Come over here, measure 4 foot, and then to make a perfect triangle, that will measure 5 foot from mark to mark. And that's how you know that you're square. You can even do that on both sides too, since we're so odd of a shape. All right, so clearly what you can see that I'm doing is I'm just capping all the tops. This is some old milled stuff that I have laying around because I'm lazy and I don't feel like milling anymore. But it's going in the woods anyway, and it's strong, and it'll be sweet. So I'll get back to you when I get all these out. Okay, so now that we got all these cut, we're gonna put them all in place. Then we're gonna nail the hell out of it. But don't worry, I already crowned them and all first, but just to make this a lot easier on your brain. What crowning is making sure the grain is up, so basically the rainbow facing up, and that works for both ways. I'm not too worried about the edges because I'm going to cut those off later.
So this is my finished product. I ended up putting some tin on the bottom and some extra support just so when they hit it didn't break any piece individually. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe.